Hello. Today I'd like to show you the potential that Laura has as a character and what she can do. Because recently, well, not recently, for a while now, all I've been hearing about Laura is how she's the worst character in the game, like how she's bottom three, like next to the likes of like Fong and Zangief, like right above Fong, but right below Alex, who's apparently also really bad, which is kind of bullshit. But I digress. My point is, with this tutorial, I'd like to make you, if you had any interest in Laura, and if you were scared away because you heard how bad she was, or if you just think Laura's bad, I'd like to provide a little something to make you think otherwise. And if I can't make you think otherwise, I'd at least like to show off all she has to offer, because I feel that even a lot of players like that play her, such as Wolf Crone, etc., they're not using her to her fullest extent, and I'd like to just stop that. I'd like to just show you what she can do so you can get a feel of what Laura is, because I feel you're not getting that. So anyway, to start you off, I'll show you her buttons. Her light punch, 3 frames plus 2 on block. Hold on. Okay. So, sorry about that. Now, 3 frame. It's a 3 frame jab. It hits really good. It hits crouchers. Yeah, it's really good. On counter, I'll just show you. So, see, it's plus 2. Alright, to show you, right now, Nikali is set on his 3 frame jab. So just to show you, not everyone in this game has a 3 frame jab. A lot of the time, everyone in the game is obligated to have at least a 4 frame jab. What Nikali has is a 3 frame jab. Just in case some people have like special 3 framers. So just to show you how this works, on 3 framers, you can do stuff like this. So you don't have to worry about ever getting outsped with Laura. So her light punch allows things like this. Alright, not exactly this. But her light kick, however, is not plus 2, but plus 3. And her crouching heavy punch is a 7 frame attack. So plus 3 on 7 frames should be about, what, 4? Oh, shit. I'm sorry about that. It doesn't exactly work there, but we'll get to the 4 frames later. But right now, just 3 frames, which you can do. Boom, boom. Even, just so you know, even on knockdown. Damn it. Knockdown. There. So now that you know, even on knockdown, 3 frames. Boom. See? If they wake up jab, they wake up jab, and if it's a 3 framer, you still outspeed it. Hell, even with your 4 frame, if your light kick, which is a 4 framer, you can outspeed it. If I can do this. God damn it. There. So, what this means is that Laura is one of the faster people. She's one of the faster people. When it comes to speed, she's all about it. And this also works like in with her plus frames, with all of her buttons that have all types of like frame advantage and whatnot. But yeah. God damn it. So yeah, to see just how she beats out 3 framers, you got this. Alright, you got this, you got this, you got this, which you can combo from like this, this. Oh shit. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Like, okay, but. Alright. Something like that. something like, you know what I mean. You can go for stuff. Like boom, boom. You got boom, boom. You got boom, boom. On four framers, which we'll get into later, but yeah, you can like do this after this, which is really good. But especially since you know, when you do this, like people are just inclined to throw out a button, but if they don't have a three framer, boom, crushes anything that they have, like instantly. So you can go into like boom, yeah. But yeah, another thing that fucks over three framers essentially is stuff like this. You see what I mean? Now, let me explain. The way that this works is Laura, no matter it's a four framer or it's a three framer, stuff like this will always happen when you do this with Laura. And that's good, because that introduces frame trapping, like, to a lot level. Like, be aware, with Laura, a lot of this is gonna be frame trapping. Just so, to start you off, like, right now, just be aware, a lot of frame trapping is gonna be going on with Laura. So, essentially, one of her simplest frame traps is just this. Boom. So, if you do crouching, this is, like, plus one, right? So, this is plus one. Boom. It trades. Now you might think, well, it trades, like that's, like, if you're unwise, you think, oh, it trades, so that's not good. But let me show you. All of it comboed. So for the little bit of damage that you just took, you just did that much combo damage and stun to Nicali. Or if you do this, plus two. Ugh, damn it. Boom. Right there. You can do something like that. Or boom. 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 Etc. Etc. So you catch my drift. So yeah. This thing opens up a lot to you. So if you do standing light punch, three framer, plus two, boom. You'll always win out. You do something like that. If you do something like this, it'll trade. If you do, because this is the light one right here. The thing about light is it's negative two. So it's not really punishable. It's not very punishable, and it covers a pretty big distance. And yeah. You can't throw like a three frame after it, because you'll get countered. So yeah, if it gets blocked, you have to block, or if it gets blocked, then you have to also block. So, or if you think your opponent's gonna tech, you grab, anyway. So yeah, but the point is, there's that. The medium is bad. Medium of this attack is good on hit, bad on block, because it's always punishable. This is like negative seven, I think. It's really punishable. You don't want to do it. But as you see, if you do the medium, on that three frame will always win out. However, if you do it on light punch, it trades just the same way as this will trade. So what that means is with three framers, boom, like as you saw right there, three framers get stuffed. If you try to ever stuff it, if anybody ever wants to try to stuff it, boom. You get stuffed, no trade, but crush. They get countered, so you can go like that. If they try to actually trade with this one, sometimes they'll win out, but they can win out, as you see, but sometimes they'll trade. So it's kind of like, if you like So it's kind of like they might want to take a chance, but they could win. Could win, but a lot of chance they won't. And when they don't, boom. And we'll get into that a little bit later. But yeah. And essentially, another thing is with Laura, people consider her a grappler. I'm not sure if I would consider her exactly a grappler, but her grabs are rather essential for her. Let me explain to you why. So, grab. Forward grab, it knocks them a bit of a ways, right? You might think, well, that's really bad because Laura's off close character. Boom. With this attack, plus her forward grab, also I have it on back. Have everything on back reversal. So after I do everything, they should like roll back if they can. After forward grab, they cannot roll back, plus you can do this. They cannot roll back, you do this, get the counter. If you do it any later, you'll probably get a trade. Do it any later, you'll either get stuff or you could potentially get a trade. And a trade will always work in your favor. Just know that. But on the off chance, like, you see, you can do it too early, so you kind of got to time yourself on it. But, like I said, boom. And also on hit, boom, boom. On hit, that's plus two. What that means is, when it's plus two, is that for your grab is 5 frames, your command grab is 6 frames. So this is 5. So if they try to like do, so after you do this on hit, if they try to like 3-frame grab punch you or something, you could just throw out this and it'll automatically beat out their 3-frame jab. This will beat out 4-frame jabs, but this will beat out 3-frame jabs. But yeah. Her back leaves the enemy closer to you. But unlike with this fucking Akali. Or sometimes you have the option of something like this, which beat out his 30 frame. So yeah, you have those options. Or if you know that they're going to, whatchamacallit, you know they're going to hit, and if you don't want to go for this one, they always just boom, boom, like that. Get a little bit more damage, just etc. Have the armor behind it, etc. And because, since when you're glowing yellow, like as you see, you're glowing yellow. When you glow yellow, they're always going to assume, like, you're going to go for whatchamacallit. So, a lot of them are either going to jump to combo punish, or they're going to be ballsy and just show that they're not afraid by hitting you. Just hitting you with a 3-frame, 4-frame, whatever. Thing is, with this one, this isn't a grab. They go for a jump, you hit them out of the air. They go for a jab like this, you have armor, you go through it. And you can do this, which presents you a setup. So yeah. And it all kind of looks, god damn it. So from this to this, it all kind of looks the same. This gets a little bit more distance than this. But from a distance where they both hit, that's really punishable, but this is a grab. So it's a guess on their part too. So, anyway, so that's the forward grab, right? Also, you can do that. This is her forward heavy punch. It's -2, so again, not punishable. It's not exactly punishable, like it just leaves you in mix-up opportunity between either blocking or getting grabbed. But when you do the forward grab, if they press any buttons, because again, they see you doing the move, so they're inclined to press a button, right, to try to stop it. Well, it results in crush counter, it results in a counter attack, which you can, using your power, like this. Alright, so that's all from her forward grab. Now into her back grab. From her back grab, the thing is, she has this. For back grab, you can kind of go in closer to just do something like this, get a counter hit, they just see you with dash, so their entire thing is jab, so you jab, three frame it. In case you want to like do a little bit, if you want to fuck with them a little bit more, you can try to like do something like that. Do something like this. If they all outspeed three framers. All of your stuff, my point, besides that. And this. And basically, if it's below six frames, they all beat out three framers. So you could go that route. You could go this route. You could go this route. They all beat out, like, wake up jab. Just mash jab. They all beat it out, which can get you all types of results. But if they block, whatchamacallit, they block, you can, like I said, do this, this, or with the light kick, you introduce your grappling mix-ups. Because this is plus three. So remember what I told you. This, like, standing light kick, plus three. 5 frames. 6 frames. So guess what? When you're plus three, beat out three framers. Standard grab, no matter what it is, beats out three framers. Beats out three framer. Not only that, but your command grab beats out three framers. You don't get any of this from this. If you do the standing one, they all get beat out. But the standing light kick. Boom. So you introduce that with this. And if they don't press a button, then you always have this. Even a 5-framer like this beats out a 3-frame wake-up jab. So you have the option of just going for this. It's not as fast as a 3-framer, but that's where it gets good. Because it's not as fast, they'll be like, maybe I have a chance. Like, it's not as fast, so boom, you get them. Or, again, being smart, or 5 frames. It's not as fast as either of them. But you get it all the same. But my point is, they block, you go for the mix-up. Okay, so they block. Okay. So they block. Oh. Sorry about that. Damn it. So, it was my mistake. This whips. But the thing is, if you've done it before in a match, chances are they'll probably be like, wait. Like, oh shit. Like, from here, oh wait. See, because it works there. But if you do it here, it doesn't work. But when you throw it out, they're gonna be like, wait, it didn't work? And then you hit them with 3-framer, or hit them with this. And then you can combo into this. You get me? So, now with all of that out of the way, always the option of this as well. If you wanna go for crush counter, you can walk forward a little bit. Crush counter. Just, again, walk forward, crush counter. Boom. Boom. Full punish. Or, like, as you see, got beaten out. Oh shit, I am awful. Anyway, so say they don't want to throw out a button. Okay. Say they don't want to throw out a button. right? Say they don't want to throw out a button. Boom. 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 Oh, wait. God damn it. God damn it! Alright. So, say they don't want to throw out a button here. Boom. They throw out a button that time, so boom. Now, when you go... When you go like this, you'll lose. Using the regular grab, you'll lose. But, using the command grab, you'll never lose. So yeah, but the thing is, they'll probably know, sometimes your opponent might know that. They might know that after this, this will always connect. This might not connect. And the thing is, when this doesn't connect, it's not that bad. If they jumped, if they think that you're going for this, but instead you do this, they're gonna jump. And when they jump, you can punish this. If they jumped away, you can do that. Or just dash forward. If they jump toward, you can dash under. You can do whatever. You can meet them in the air, meet them halfway. Just, you have all types of options. This, like I said, you got all options. If they jump, you have options. So, if they jump this, full punish. Jump this, you full punish them. So, if they know that you're gonna do that, if they know that you're gonna go for this, you could just probably throw out this instead. So just whip it on purpose. Just, you whip it on purpose, and yeah. Next time, if you do that, they're gonna think, oh, he's gonna whip it on purpose. Go for it. Another thing, with the back grab, I think we were all talking about the back grab, so yeah. So back grab, boom. God damn it. Back grab, you have, God damn it. Back grab! Crush counter. You have crush counter. Don't even gotta move. Crush counter. Oh. Like, don't even gotta move here. Crush counter. Crush counter. Trade. Trade! Sometimes. Sometimes they'll trade, and as you see from the little damage that you took opposed to the damage that he just took, is a trade worth it? So you can mix them up. So you can like mix your opponent up by doing overhead, trade. Or, and guess what? And yeah, sweep. Or overhead. As you see, at worst, it could just do that. At worst, it puts you in a mix-up opportunity. At worst. But, you know, it's not that bad. So, yeah. That's all from this. All from this stuff. The next thing we get to is the, next thing that we're getting into. This. Now, here's the thing about this one. As you see, it leaves you at an awkward distance. You can't, if you try to dash in, you get hit. If you try this, you get hit. And at the same time, you could do that. You could do that, but most people won't throw out buttons at that distance. You know, most people won't exactly throw out buttons at that distance. You could also do this, which I'm kind of a fan of. Which I'm kind of a fan of, which is not getting hit, but rather this. Again, sometimes it'll work. Sometimes you just need to walk a little bit forward and just, there. However, here, overhead does not work. But here's the thing. Here's the good part about this. See? Now watch. Boom. Got counter. That means, is guess what? Whoop! Boop, boop. Again. And then from there, you can go into this. You can go into boom, 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 boom. You can do maybe this. And then, like, you have all types of options. You have, oh God. You have all types of options with her, is the point that I'm trying to bring across. So even after her command grab, you have just all types of options. Just fucking crazy how many options you have. So, we have that. But that's not all. You see, because the thing about Laura is she's also got these babies, which if you do it this way, if you do the punches, they'll kind of switch sides and leave them close to you. In which, when you're that close, you can score a... When you're that close, you can score a crush counter. You can, again, you might not know who's gonna throw a button, but you'll be surprised how much it works. Score a crush counter, score a sweep. I don't think here the overhead won't work, but again, just, you got all this stuff. You got this. You don't have that. You don't have that. Never mind. But yeah, you might not have that, but say on the off chance that they, they know not to throw the button, because... Okay, can't do that. So they know not to throw the button because of crush counter. So what you do is you scare them with the crush counter threat. You can either do this, they can't punish, or you can either do this. Sometimes this might miss, but this will never miss. You also try sweep. Those never miss. Never. Hold on. I'm gonna wake up. There you go. Never miss. So, what you're gonna do is, whoop, do that. Do that to get in. And yeah, got them on edge. But, yeah. So that's what you have from there. But that's not it. That's not only it. Again, wake up. So you got. You saw that one, that was cute, right? Well, how about this? Leaves you at a further distance, but here's the kicker. Even though this will leave you at a further distance, you can actually do this. Beats out 3 framers. Boom. Again. Overhead might not work. Might not work! But sweep works all the same. And yeah, you can't dash in on them because, you know, but you don't need to dash in on them because guess what? You don't need to rush in on them because of this. See what I mean? If they press a button, you get them. And remember, this is a -2. So even if they block, not punishable. So it's safe either way. And if they want to just like go, oh, like I'm just not gonna press anything. Like, and if, you know, they are again against the options. Again, if they are against the options, then guess what? Got it. All the same. But that's not it. We still have one more upper sleeve. One more. Which, her last grab and mix-up, the last grab that you have to worry about, is not actually a grab. It kind of is a grab. It's her anti-air. It's kind of like a DP. It's this one. You always see it at the end of combos like this, like, ah, like, ah, but here's the kicker about all of this. This one, you can keep the pressure. You might be wondering, how exactly are you going to keep the pressure? Like, what can you do? You can't dash in an overhead. Like, you can't do that. If you dash in like that, you're just gonna get hit. So what are you gonna do? Well, this still works. And if that still works, then that means that this still works. But not only does it work, it now gives you a trade. And we were, if you remember anything about the trade before, is it gives you either a counter or at worst a trade. And yeah, we all remember, as a counter, you have all types of options. You have, this is an option. And if it trades, if you can somehow time the trade even, oh my god. You can somehow time the trade, or if they throw out like a four framer and if it trades, well, even better. But yeah, overhead does not work. But yeah, you got this, and boom. Hold on, boom. God damn it. God damn it. I don't think it works. I don't even think it works. There. It does. You can even, after that, if you decide to do this, beats out three framers. And what can you do if it beats out three framers? Boom, etc. You have all types of, again, options. With Laura, she has all kind of options that you can go into. That's what I want to bring up. And not only that, but since we're bringing up this thing, remember, -2. This is really bad on block, but on hit, it's a gift. Let me explain to you why it's a gift. Backroll that, but... You see? Even if they backroll it, even if they quick get up, you're at so much advantage. I fucked it up, but you get my point. You can do something like this. So much advantage, you can do something like that. So much advantage, boom, like that. Like, you're at advantage. Like, a lot of advantage. Like, a lot of advantage, is my point. So you just come in, you do that. Say they expect the overhead. They expect the overhead, right? At this point, you could just, all day. At this point, you could just do this all day. So they're expecting the overhead at this point. Well, guess what? Boom, boom, if I can do it. Boom. Sweep. And remember, sweep gets all the range. But as you can see from where the turtle's sitting, like this one, not as much range as the sweep. But at that range, that where you're at, you can just throw that out too. Like, it really does not matter. So, again, you have this. Do something like that. So if at some points this might actually cross up, so you could just, again, options. That's what I'm trying to get into. Options. You, with Laura, you have all kind of options, which come into, if I can stop fucking this shit up. You see, I'm on so much advantage that it's hard to time this stuff. It is hard to time it because of how much advantage I'm at. But yeah, options. That's one area. So we covered this, You always could do this, but there's no reason to. Like, you can't do any like type of pick me up or something from it. The worst thing is you just like, ooh, and then like you go behind them and then you can be like, ah, guess what, motherfucker, ah! And, but that's not that great. But you wanna know what is great? This. Putting her V-skill to actual use. Using her V-skill like this also leaves you really advantageous. maybe not as advantageous as this, but that's good. Because with that one, you are like 2,000% advantageous. Here, boom. Gotcha. Oh god. Boom, boom, boom. Oh god. God damn it. Hold on. Boom, boom, boom. Boom. Advantageous. You know what I mean? So you got that. You got, boom, 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 boom. You get it! You're very advantageous. Very, very advantageous. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, shit. Well, that did not work. That did not work. But, I don't know. If they were blocking, it probably could work. Like, that's the point that I'm trying to get across. If they were blocking, it probably could work. You have all types of options. All types of options from this. From overhead. Sweep. Crush counter. Grab. Command grab. Options. All kind of options you have. All kind. You know, that's... And the thing is, we haven't even gotten into one of the bigger parts. Those are a little bit. Those play a huge part in Laura. Those play a part of Laura. Like, a big part of Laura's mix-up game and what makes her scary. That's not even it. That's not even all of it. Now we can get to frames. This, 5 frames plus 2. 5 frames plus 2. Boom. Boom, boom. Like, 5 frames. Okay. Now, let's play with the more common ground. Because here's the thing. Like I said, very few characters have a 3-frame, and even then, not all their stuff is 3-frame. It's a very specific attack of theirs that has 3 frames. So, what this means is you're going to be dealing with a lot of 4-frame people. And my god, does Laura have shit for 4-framers. Boom. Like, boom. Just for starters, boom. You can do this. Boom. You can do this. You can do this. You can do fucking this. Well, that beats out 3-framers, but like, you get my point. You get my point. This is 0. This is 0 on block. So, boom. This is 0 on block, meaning that when you throw a button after this, either your 4-frame 0, so whatever you throw out after this could trade with a 4-framer potentially. But yeah, again, but this, like, it's 5 frames at that point. This comes out at 5 frames, so may not be the best, but you get this from this. And you might not realize it, but here's the thing. Block strings. Here's her block strings of what you can do. Boom, boom, boom. All of this, if you try to interrupt between this, this, or this, get interrupted. Try to interrupt between this, this. Interrupt. You're fucked. Try to interrupt between this, this. Well, try to interrupt between this, this, you're fucked. And try to interrupt between, I believe this is 3 frames, so this, this, you're fucked. This, this, fucked. Fucking this, this, you're fucked. Like, try to interrupt between this or this, you're fucked. This, this, you're fucked. Like, fucking this, you're fucked. This, you're fucked. This, you're fucked. This, you're fucked. Like, you're fucked is my point that I'm trying to get across. Like, a lot of shit she can do that, like, this is double plus three. This is plus three plus three. So at this point, if you block this and this, this, and this. So, and if you, in case you don't understand this, all of it, you gotta take all of it. If you don't take all of it, then you're gonna get all of it. So you just gotta block it. You just block, and look at the space that it gives you. And if you don't want that space, you wanna keep that pressure, negative two, remember, save. You can always do this. This is like plus one, so, there, boom. You want to stop it? Like, you want to stop it, buddy? So it'd be like, you want to stop this, buddy? Counter. Want to stop this, buddy? You want to stop this, buddy? Want to stop this, buddy? Like, to the point where, if you're playing with four framers, this isn't even plus three. This is plus two frames. This is just plus two frames. So, you can go as dangerous as this. Don't have to worry about getting traded. Just block it. That's all I gotta do. Also, another thing that I don't think many people realize is try this. If they have a three framer, your dash gets punished. Dash gets punished. Three framer punishes grabs. Four framer, not punished. Now you can't exactly press a button after this. You try to get your three frame jab out, you're gonna get hit. But if you do this on someone like Ken, who doesn't have, I mean, you probably shouldn't do this on Ken because he has a three frame button. But say you're doing this on somebody with a DP who doesn't have three fucking frames, okay? They see you dash, their first instinct is to boom, DP. But what this means is that most DPs aren't three frames. So block it. If they have a DP, you block it. Case in point, you can do things like this. Oh. You do things like this. Okay, you can't do that. You don't want to do that. But her medium punch buttons are all just allow you to just V-skill in safely against anything that's not a three framer. As long as it's not three frames or fewer, you're good. You could just fucking boom. Boom, boom, boom. Just like. Alright, so you get it. She's advantageous, this just leaves you at a mix-up. So if they go for a DP, boom, etc. Go for a DP, you get that. Go for a four frame, you get a mix. Go for four frame, you get a mix-up. You either block, or grab. That's all you get. But as a trade, you get to stay on it. And if they are afraid, if you manage to like get them afraid of you, you could just do boom, 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 fucking boom, 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 boom. You know, you got options. Is what I'm trying to tell. Reoccurring theme. For the Matsuda clan, what's their biggest strength? Options is what I'm trying to bring into you. Now, you've seen also her stun, her damage and stuff. Be aware, I'm showing you, like, right now we are probably halfway through everything. Halfway through. All right, so what do we know? Now her medium punches, all of her medium punches allow a safe B skill dash in. Fucking, also, if you got four framers, guess what? Boom, boom, safe, safe, not so safe. But also, not only do they allow for this, but they allow for this. I mean, given that on block, this is not safe, but on hit, boom, boom. Like on hit, just boom, boom. Like, ah, god damn it. Boom, boom. On hit, like they can hit you, my point is. You try to interrupt this, they'll hit you. In fact, see? In fact, if you want to try to interrupt this, like, oh! There. Like, oh god. Boom. 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 Like, that's, yeah. I mean, it might seem bad. It seems bad, but just keep that in mind. Keep that shit in mind. Alright. So, what have we shown? We saw how powerful her heavy kick is. Sweep. This. After. When it comes to two. When it comes to four frame people, which is the majority of the cast, just do this. This is. That's plus one, so this plus six, so you can fucking everything. Boom, boom, fucking, you get it. You get it. Do you get it? Do you get it? Yes, you get it. If you don't, then I'll fucking smack you. So yeah. Now we should probably go into. something, I don't know. Capcom likes to make this sound a lot harder than it is. It's not that hard. What I'm talking about is Bonita mode. Bonita mode? Bonita mode. Now, your dashes are your skill, you go way further. Now look, command grab. 150 damage, 210 stun. Do it now. 180 damage, 220 stun. Does more, noticeably more. 180, 200. 210 and 220. You get it? You fucking get it. This? Now look. 141, 185 stun. 141 damage, 185 stun. 169 damage, 235 stun. No damage difference, but guess what? Duration. Way less? Oh my god! Okay, but seriously, this actually means something, because you remember that little setup that I showed you beforehand? You remember this? Bonita mode. Boom. Bonita mode. Oh, hold on. Bonita mode. Like. Like, okay. Bonita. Just, you see what I mean? Do ya see it? Do ya see it? Like, do you see Bonita mode? Like, do you understand Bonita mode? Like, do you understand it now? Now, I'll give you this. It's not exactly that fast. It ain't that fast, but believe me, it's not that fast for a reason. But what you can do... Oh, shit. Hold on. Can do... Ah! So, Bonita mode. Oh, god damn it! Fucking damn it. Oh, god damn it. I'm doing an awful job, I know. Shut up. Something like that. Something like that. See what I mean? Bonita mode. Bonita! All of your attacks. Not only all of your attacks, not just this. From 100 stun, 60 damage. 70. 70 damage, 150 stun. 254 damage, 370 stun. 410 stun, 278 damage. Even your B skill. 90 damage, 150 stun. 100 damage, 200 stun. What that means, mind you, it means this. See what I mean? Do you understand? Do you understand what Bonita can do in this mode? I don't think you do. Her super also does a little bit more. Like, as you see from the damage of her super here, 350 versus Bonita mode, 370. Now, I don't know if I actually assume that, like, maybe the speed of the attack will also increase. Like, maybe the speed of the attack also increases. Something like that, right? I don't know. Point is, I don't fucking know. I really don't know. This, it lasts on screen for a while. Allows enough for like one dash, but EX, it also lasts for a while. Not full screen now. Not exactly full screen now. Not as far, but catch this, get this. No. Bonita mode. Bonita mode. Huh? I'll break it down to you. It's because in Bonita mode, the EX Lightning Bolt picks them up even further, allowing for not only because of your increased fucking gas potential, but whatchamacallit, you can do things like this. Do things. With your newly increased dash potential, you can do things like this. Or like this. God damn it. Or like this. Or like this. Or basically. Or like this. God damn it. Or. Oh, god damn it. You get my point. You get my point. Like something like that. I don't know. You options. Again, options. You fucking have options. That's the point that I'm trying to get across. I'm trying to get across the fact that you have options. Alright, motherfuckers? Stop trying to be. Alright, be like, well, we're waiting. You know what I mean. Damn it. Options. Motherfucker. Boom. Like, options. You have options. That's what I'm trying to get across. Bonita mode expands all of those options. Not only for more damage, but all types of things. Your dash, hell of a lot better. Yes, attacks, hell of a lot more stun. Fucking charging your thing. Better. Everything on Bonita is better. Except this. I mean, this does a hell of a lot more stun. It does, I don't know, honestly, if you ask me for how punishable and how bad this attack is, this Bonita mode should beat this all the time with the amount of stun that it does. But whatever. You get my point. Bonita. Even though, unlike a lot of other people's V triggers, where their V skill would actually increase the amount of, an overhead does not increase the amount of her V gauge, which could be intentional. But, I don't know. That's Bonita in a nutshell for you. I mean, she obviously has a lot of bad matchups and stuff, but I'm just here to tell you about her tools and everything that she can do. I guess I can get into, like, her whatchamacallit. Another thing that I don't see utilized ever is this. Because here's the thing. You can do this, but you can't do this into... You see, you can't combo that. You could also do this. You could also combo that. Or you can combo this, you can do this. You can do this. Or you can do this. See what I mean? Options. Actually, hold on. Actually, and you get it. Options. Oh no, that's Bonita. Again, 3-5 frames. Plus 2, so this beats, so together, beats out on 3 framers, etc. Basically frame data. Another thing that you should know about Laura is her frame data. I'm not gonna go into all that shit that I haven't already. This is 6 frames, 7 frames, 12 frames, not like 9 frames or some shit, 6 frames, 5 frames, 3 frames, 4 frames, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 2, plus 3, plus 1, 0, negative 4, like negative 4 or something, I don't know, something surprisingly negative, punishable. This is only negative 4, this attack is only negative 4, which makes it